Good morning, children. So here the 5th class children, the lesson number 5, and here is the page number 202. This is the subject of science. So how are you children? I hope you are fine and you are eating a healthy food and spending the time with your siblings, learning a lot of things at your home. And you are helping your parents as well as you are doing the works which we are giving. Okay, so here the R skeletal system. Pick the correct sentences. Our body works like a machine. Yes, correct. This is the correct sentence, children. We can see the heart and lungs in our body. No, we cannot see. Our body is made up of 206 bones of different sizes and shapes and sizes. Yes, it's correct. We can move our elbow and knee in all directions. Not all directions, but we can move in the few parts. Okay, so almost all direction we can move. So it can be false. Okay, our bones control our actions like seeing and walking. No, this is not correct. Okay. Next one, you please you do this, children. Next one is here. Think of the things a computer can do. Now think of all the things you can do. Isn't your list much longer? Our body is more efficient. What is this, children? Efficient. Efficient means which is unable to do, which has the capacity. That is called as efficient. Efficiency, efficiency. Than any other human-made machine. Now think of all the functions that your body performs and so many of them at the same time. How do we hear? How do we see? How does our heart beat? How is our food digested? How do we remember things? Let us understand how our body works. So these are the things which automatically does our body. Okay, it is done by our body itself. Okay, and then what happened, children? See, this is the machine, how it's work, how it has the capacity. So now how our body works, let us see. Our body is made up of many parts, each of which perform special functions. The lungs, the heart, the kidneys, and the brain are some of the major organs of our body. These organs have to work like a team in order to keep the body fit. So, in order to keep the body fit, what all the organ system has to work functionally and very in a perfect manner, it has to be do. Okay, it is like a teamwork. The teamwork of our bones and muscles is amazing. Working together, they make our body an efficient machine. Okay, so all the body, they are continuously working, means it can be used as a efficient machine, which can do proper functioning. That is called as efficiency. A group of organs together make an organ system. So a group of organs together make what, children? They are made up of organ system. For example, the digestive systems help in the digestion of food, and the muscular systems keep our muscles strong and gives us strength. The nervous system controls the working of internal organs of our movements and even our thoughts and emotions. The circulatory, the respiratory, and the reproductive systems perform their own functions. So they are performing their own functions. Okay, children. So they are the internal. We cannot see our internal body, but they are functional of their own. Yes. So first one is what, children? This our lesson is about the skeletal system. So this is the skeleton. As you can see, the skeletal system. This is the highest, largest bone in our body. That is femur. That is called as femur, and that is also called as humerus. Okay, this is the skull. This is the shoulder girdle. This is the hip girdle. This is the backbone. It has 33 bones. Yes, and this is the rib cage. Okay. The human skeleton is a framework of bones. This framework of bones encloses and protects all the internal organs and gives a support, strength, and shape to the body. An adult human has 206 bones of different sizes and shapes in his body. The human skeleton consists of the skull, backbone, rib cage, and the two pairs of limbs. forelimbs, arms, and the hind limbs, legs. These limbs are attached to pairs of girdle, shoulder girdle and hip girdle respectively. This is the shoulder girdle, children. So these are attached the forelimbs. These, the hands are called as, the arms are called as forelimbs. The shoulder girdle, it is attached to the legs and they are called as hind limbs. Okay. Now, next one is skull. The skull is made up of 22 bones, 8 flat bones interlocked together. Enclose the delicate brain inside it. So the skull has what, children? It protects our brain. Okay. There are 14 bones in the facial region. Among them, the lower jaw is movable. It enables us to talk and eat and talk. Only the lower jaw can be movable. Okay. The backbone or spine. The skull is attached to the backbone, which forms the main axis of the skeleton. It is made up of 33 bones called vertebrae, which form a strong column called the vertebral column. So it is also called as vertebral column, and the humans are also called as vertebrae. Okay. The vertebral column protects the delicate spinal cord. So the spinal cord here at the backbone here it is present, children. Here it is present and it here it is present, and it protects the delicate spinal cord. Okay, next one is the rib cage. There are 12 pairs of bow shaped ribs which form a cage and enclose the heart and lungs. The ribs are delicate curved bones which are joined to the backbone and the breastbone. This is called as is breastbone. Okay, the lowest one are floating bones, are called as, they are called as floating bones, and this is breastbones. Okay, these are bow shaped what you call as ribs. Okay, and they are protecting the lungs. Okay, children, now I hope you have understand. This is skeleton, skull, backbone and the rib cage. Now turn to the page number next, children. That is page number 204. The lowest two pairs are called floating ribs, are joined to the backbone. They are floating bones and they are joined to the backbone. The limbs, the four limbs and the arms are joined to the spine with the help of the shoulder girdles, consisting of a pair of shoulder blades and a pair of collar bones. Okay, it is consists, the limbs are consisting of what, children? Collar bones. I have shown you right in the Zoom class. The powerful thigh bone is called as femur, bears the weight of the whole body. It bears what, children? It bears the weight of the whole body. It is the longest bone in our body. Okay, the femur fits into the hip girdle with the ball and socket joint, and it is connected to a lower leg at the knee point. The long bones of a skeleton are hollow and filled with a soft fatty substance that is called as bone marrow. So this is the arm. Okay, this is the bones of the arm, and this is the bones of a leg. This is called as femur. Okay, now what are the functions of the skeleton? First, it gives shape, strength and support to the body. It protects our internal organs. Second one. Okay, and what are the internals? The skull covers the delicate brain. The skull is it covers the delicate brain. The eyeballs rest inside the bony eye sockets. The backbone protects the spinal cord, and the rib cage protects the lungs and the heart. The urinary bladder lies inside the hip girdles. So obviously the urinary bladder, kidneys, they are the inside the hip girdles, and the rib cage, they protects the lungs and the heart. Not only that, the pancreas, the gallbladder, the liver, even they are protecting this also. Okay, children, the muscles are attached to the bones and make movement possible. So which are the things that are helping us to move? That are muscles. In the middle of some bones there is soft metal called as bone marrow, as we have learned there. Okay, this bone marrow produces blood cells. So this bone marrow, what produces the blood cells. Fact wise, bones are not the hardest substance in our body.
The animal coating on our teeth is harder than bones. However, bones can be repaired if broken, but the animal cannot. Only the animal of the teeth cannot repair itself. They are the only part, and that is the strongest part of our body in the bones. Okay. Next one, checkpoint children, check this out. A group of organs together make up a organ system, tissue or a cell. That is organ system. Please circle this organ system. The skull is made up of obviously 22 bones. Okay, 8 is facial flat bones and 14 is the facial region bones. Okay. The backbone is made up of 33 small bones called vertebrae, not ribs, not bone marrow. Okay, this one you want circle, children. Next one is what, children? Next one is joints. A joint is the meeting point of two bones held together by strong tissues called ligaments. So, if the joints which they are their meeting point with the help of strong tissues, they are called as ligaments. There are several joints in our body. All the joints except those in the skull are movable. The bones in the skull are interlocked, making the joints immovable. And moreover, the skull joints are flat also. Okay. The movable joints. So, in this lesson, we are going to learn about only the movable joints. The bones at the joints move smoothly because of the fluid which acts as a lubricant. Okay, lubricant is that substance and that fluid which helps the joints to move very smoothly. Okay, there are four types of movable joints in our body. A hinge joint is like a hinges in the door. It can move the bones only in one direction. The elbows, knees, fingers and the toes have hinge joints. So you know about the hinge joint, right? It is like a at one place, the how the door is open and closed, it is the same, the hinge joint is present. I have shown in the Zoom class also. A ball and socket joint allows the maximum movement as displayed by the ballet dancers. One bone that ends in a ball fits into a socket and the other. Hip and shoulder joints are of this type. Okay, you don't take this example for ballet dancer, you just take the example for ball and socket joint. One is the socket, one is the ball, okay. And how they can revolve in that. Okay, a pivot joint is found between the skull and the first two vertebrae of the spine. The uppermost vertebrae in the neck is called atlas. We can move our head sideways, upward, downward with the help of the pivot joint. Okay, last one is what, children? The gliding joint. The gliding joint allows movement at the wrist and ankle and also between two vertebrae of the spine. It allows our back to bend, twist and turn each joint. What would happen if your backbone was end up just one long bone? It would make you lift as stiff as scarecrow. If your gliding joints and joints are not movable, children, you are stiff as the scarecrow. You know now why we are using the scarecrow in the fields, right? So these are the all types of joints. This is the hinge joint, here the elbows and fingers, the ball and socket joint, the shoulder and the hip girdle, the pivot joint, here the pivot joint is first two vertebrae and first vertebrae is called as atlas, and the gliding joints at the ankle and the wrist. So, for these examples, you can easily get to know that where they are present, okay, different types of joints. Okay, next one, children, muscles and movement. The muscles in the body tighten and relax to produce movement. There are about 650 muscles in the body and each one causes a particular movement, obviously. Actually, there are more than 650 muscles, and these muscles actually till the research is going on, but it is not that correct or the appropriate one. Okay, muscles bend our arms, knees, push food into the digestive canal, allow us to inhale air into our lungs, help us to chew our food and make our heart beat. These all the muscles are doing, children. Okay. Muscles are attached to the bones by the strong fibers. They are called as tendons. So here we have learnt about the ligaments, about the joints. Here we are going to learn about the tendons. The muscles are attached to the bones. They are called as tendons. These fibers become stronger with the regular exercise. It means you are doing exercise. It means you are your strong fibers are becoming more strong. Okay, they are called as tendons. Okay, now next one is types of muscles. Some muscles, like the muscle attached to our skin, are under our control. So we call them voluntary muscles. Muscles not under our control are called as involuntary muscles, as I have explained you this one. They control actions like the movement of food in the alimentary canal, the flow of blood, and the movement of the eye muscles. Okay, all the involuntary muscles, like they are not under in control, like flow of blood, movement of food in the alimentary canal, right? The third kind of muscles are found in the heart, which are involuntary in function, but they are structured like a voluntary muscles. These muscles are cardiac muscles. Not only this, we have seen in the Zoom class that striated muscles and striated muscles are there, smooth muscles are there. Yes, yes. Next one, children, turn the page. Page number 206. Oh God, I have turned one more page extra. Here, children, how do muscles work? Muscles produce movement in the body by pulling on the bones. When a muscle contracts, the bones come close to each other. When the knee bends, the muscle contracts and gets shorter, whereas the other one relaxes. When the leg stretches, the reverse happens. Well-developed muscles give a graceful appearance to the body. To keep the muscles in a good shape, we must maintain a good posture while we sit, stand, or walk. Our body is amazing. We must look after it well. We must exercise and rest properly. We must have a healthy diet. We must not eat junk food. So muscles along the bones help in the movement of the body. Can you see, able to see, children, all the muscles, how they are spreaded all over the body? Even in the small area, if you touch your skin, there also one of the muscles will present. Okay, children. Okay, we have completed the textual information. Now we are going to do the words to know. Please learn these meanings, children. Please learn these meanings. Vertebral, the small bones of the vertebral column. Obviously, that is backbone. Bone marrow, the soft spongy material found inside the activities of long bones. Okay. Ligaments, strong tissues that bind the bones at the joint. Tendons, strong fibers with which muscles are attached to the bones. Cardiac muscles, muscles of the heart. Let us go for the quick recap, children. Our body is made up of many parts. Each of them performs special functions. Our skeleton is a framework of bones in our body. Bones differ in shape and size. Bones give shape, support, and strength to our body. Bones give protection to the internal organs and help us to move. The backbone protects the spinal cord. The skull protects the brain. Obviously, these are because all skeletal system is for protecting, right? A joint is a meeting point of two bones held together by the strong tissues called ligaments. If they are asking what are ligaments, okay. Now next one, children, this here. The joint in the skull are immovable. There are four kinds of movable joints in the body: hinge joint, ball and socket joint, pivot joint, and the gliding joint. All the joints we have learnt about it. Voluntary muscles are under our control, whereas involuntary muscles are not. Obviously, they are talking about the types of muscles. Okay, So we will do this read and answer, the textual information, the in the Zoom class. Okay, all this one we will do this in the textual information in the Zoom class. And till here you have to, any doubts you can ask me in this, children, any doubts are there, please ask me in this. Okay, so this we have completed the textual information. Okay children, take care children, bye everyone.